Please note that this video is not meant to provide a detailed insight into the third week of development. It's merely a quick review. That's why we highly recommend that you watch our whole detailed series on this topic before you watch this review, so that you can catch up with us perfectly. As you know that at the end of second week of development, we were left with a two-layered or bilaminar germ disc present between the two cavities, that is amniotic cavity and yolk sac cavity. All the structure is covered on the outside by extra-embryonic mesoderm, cytotrophoblast, syncytiotrophoblast, and the structure is implanted into the endometrium of uterus. During third week of development, this bilaminar germ disc is converted into trilaminar, that is tri-layered embryonic disc, by the process known as gastrulation. The process starts when the cells in the caudal part of epiblast secrete certain chemical substances that causes proliferation and migration of peripheral cells towards the midline, hence producing a streak called primitive streak. This streak is delineated cranially by an ovoid swelling called Hansen's node or primitive node. The proliferated cells start pinching down, thus leaving a depression or groove behind, which is called primitive groove. They then displace the lower layer, that is hypoblast layer, thus taking its place. Some more cells come to lie in between the two layers, thus producing a third layer in between the two, hence forming a definitive three-layered germ disc. The embryo becomes a trilaminar structure except at two places, viz. Oropharyngeal membrane and cloacal membrane. The endodermal part of oropharyngeal membrane is called precaudal plate. The first few of these ingressing cells move forward in the oropharyngeal membrane. Here they displace the original precaudal plate laterally, and then these new population of cells now form the definitive precaudal plate. Cells at the caudal end of precaudal plate proliferate and form a new layer dorsal to it called precaudal mesoderm. As it happens, the oropharyngeal membrane is now restricted to cranial end only. Further cells ingressing from the primitive node towards the precaudal plate make the notochordal process. The central cells of this process then die out, and a canal called notochordal canal is formed. Notochordal canal then intercalates into the underlying endoderm. The floor of this canal is lost, and a temporary connection called neurenteric canal between the amniotic and yolk sac cavity is formed. As the floor is lost, the canal is now converted into an arc-like structure called notochordal plate. Later, the notochordal plate rolls upward and grows to form a flexible solid rod called notochord. Notochord induces the overlying ectoderm to thicken and form the neural plate. This thickened neural plate then folds inwards, joining the folds and leaving some cells called neural crest cells separated from it. This meeting of folds results in formation of neural tube, which is the precursor of future brain and spinal cord, and this process is called neurulation. The mesoderm is differentiated into different types. At the mid-axis of the embryo is the axial mesoderm, also called notochord. The part of mesoderm that runs just parallel and lateral to this axial mesoderm is called paraxial mesoderm. The most lateral one is the lateral plate mesoderm, and in between the lateral plate and paraxial mesoderm is the intermediate mesoderm. Cells that ingress from the Hansen's node form the precaudal plate and notochord. Cells that ingress from the cranial end of primitive streak form the paraxial mesoderm. Cells from the mid-streak form the intermediate mesoderm. Cells from the caudal part of streak forms the lateral plate mesoderm. And the cells from the caudal end of the streak contributes towards the extraembryonic mesoderm. Now let us revise the functions of these parts of mesoderm. Paraxial mesoderm is divided firstly into partially segmented blocks called somatomeres. Later, except first seven somatomeres, all other somatomeres are transected into completely isolated segmented bodies called somites. The somites are further differentiated into dermatomes that form the skin, myotomes that form the muscle, and sclerotome that form the axial skeleton. The intermediate mesoderm is the precursor of urogenital system. For the lateral plate mesoderm, cells within the center of lateral plate mesoderm die and form a cavity called intraembryonic coelom, thus splitting the lateral plate mesoderm into somatic and splanchnic layers. In the third week, allantois also forms. It is a sausage-like diverticulum that arises from the yolk sac into the connecting stalk. It functions in excretion of waste materials in the early embryo and forms the part of urinary bladder as the embryo develops. In this way, blood vessels are also formed. For this purpose, cells of the yolk sac wall induce the overlying extraembryonic mesoderm to form the blood islands that are aggregates of hematoblasts. The central cells of each blood island die and a cavity forms. Some cells that remain alive within this cavity are the embryonic precursors of the blood cells. The peripheral cells flatten out to form the endothelial cells. They orient themselves in such a way that they coalesce with the neighboring islands to form the long vascular cords. The mesenchymal cells around them form the surrounding connective tissue and smooth muscle. This process is called vasculogenesis. It is an exclusive embryologic process. A type of the endothelial cells called the tip cells sprout towards the VEGF and form a totally new vessel from the existing vessel. This process is called sprouting angiogenesis. In another type of angiogenesis called splitting angiogenesis or non-sprouting angiogenesis, a vessel literally splits into two. Angiogenesis is an embryologic as well as a postnatal process. Another noticeable thing at the end of second week was that embryo was covered with the primary villi that are solid finger-like processes of cytotrophoblast. In third week, a mesenchymal extension from the underlying extraembryonic mesoderm develops into the core of these primary villi, transforming them into the secondary villi. This mesenchyme then forms the blood vasculature of these villi that are now termed as tertiary villi.